Hi students, class 10, exercise number 8.2, question number 6. The time taken in minutes to complete a homework by 8 students in a day are given by 38, 40, 47, 44, 46, 43, and 49 and 53. Find the coefficient of variation. Here we want to find the coefficient of variation means first we want to know that what is the mean and what is the standard deviation. Then only we can able to find the coefficient of variation. Clearly the given data is here ungrouped data. Here we are using assumed mean method. Assumed mean method to solve this given data. So assumed mean method means first the given data is xi. And then the deviation for the assumed mean method is xi minus a. Then we want to find out di square. Now we enter the given data in the place of xi. I arranged in a ascending order to enter the given data. So the now given data is arranged in ascending order. So number of students is given as n is equal to 8 students. So the data n is equal to number of observation is 8. Now here we want to find out what is the assumed value. A is equal to assumed value is our own value and select the numbers nearer to the middle value, right? Select the numbers nearer to the middle value. Here I am going to take the 46 as the assumed value. Now we take it as 46. A is equal to 46. Now we want to find out the deviation di. 38 minus xi is 38 minus 46 is equal to 8. And here we have negative symbol as highest number, so we have minus 8. Above the 46, we have only negative value, so put the minus symbol first. And then below we have the positive value. Now 40 minus 46 is 6, minus 6, right? And then 43 minus 46 means we get 3. And then 44 minus 46 is 2. Here is the additional work, we can do it separately. Then 46 minus 46 is equal to 0, and then 47 minus 46 is equal to 1, and then 49 minus 46 is equal to 3, and then 53 minus 46 is equal to 7. Now we want to find out what is di square. Square this term, when we squaring we get only positive value. 88 are 64, 66 are 36, 33 are 9, 2 2s are 4 and then 0, 1 1s are 1, 3 3s are 9, 4 7 7s are 49. Now we want to find the mean and standard deviation. So if you want to find the mean means mean x bar is equal to, we know the formula, mean x bar is equal to summation xi divided by n. So sum of this number we need. So we want to find this one. So n is equal to here 8. Now sum of this value is equal to 12, 19, 25, 29, 32, 40, 0, remainder 4, 9, 13, 17, 21, 25, 29, 33 and 36, 360. So summation xi is equal to 360. So 360 divided by 8 is equal to, we get 45. 8 4 sir 32, remainder 4, right, 40. 8 5 sir 40. So we get x bar is equal to 45, the mean. Now we want to find the standard deviation. Standard deviation means we need to find what is the di and the summation di square. Summation di square is equal to, now add this term. See, here we have negative value. If we add the negative value, we get 5, 11, 19, minus 19. If we add this value, we get 10, 11. When you subtract this, we get minus 8 as the value. Right? Now, summation di square is equal to 19, see, 10, 19, 23, 32, 38, 42. 2 remainder, 4. 8, 11 and 17, 172. So summation di square is equal to 172 and summation di is equal to minus 8. we know the formula for standard deviation is equal to sigma is equal to root of summation di square divided by n minus summation di divided by n whole square is the formula. Now we apply the value, summation di square is equal to 172 divided by n is equal to 8 minus summation di is nothing but 8. Here we have minus 8 divided by 8 whole square is equal to root of, if you reduce this we get the value as 8 ones are 8, 2s are 16, remainder 1, 8 ones are 8, remainder 4, so 40, right? Point we get 40, we get 21.5, that is 172 is divided by 8, 8 2s are 16, remainder 1, 12, 8 1s are 8, remainder 4, point and 40, right? 8 5s are 40, we get this 21.5 minus, see 8, 8 is cancelled, we get minus 1, minus 1 square is nothing but 1. Now subtract this 2, we get 20.5 as the root value. Now we want to find the root of, so approximately we get 4 point something, let's see. Now finding the square root for 20.5, we get the value of 4.527, right? So we get 4.527 by finding the square root. Next, we are going to take only two decimal places after the point. So 5 point, it is more than 5, so add 1. So the standard deviation is 4.53. Now we want to find out coefficient of variation. CV is equal to sigma divided by x bar into 100 percentage is the formula. Now sigma is equal to 4.53 divided by x bar is, x bar we have found out that is 45 as the x bar. So x bar is equal to 45 into 100. If you multiply by 100 we get 453 divided by 45. Now divide the term, we get the value as, now 453 is divided by 45, we get 10.066 something the value. So the coefficient of variation is equal to 10.066. So we are going to take, after the decimal place we are going to take only two decimal places. So here it is more than 5, so add one number, then the coefficient of variation is equal to 10.07%. Is the answer. Thank you, students.